Someone, could you remain standing? Everyone is standing. Could you remain standing for His grace? The Right Reverend Bishop Martin. Come on, clap your hands and celebrate for him. Praise the Lord, loved ones. Say praise the Lord, everybody. Now, this is another indictment to the protocol that has been so skillfully presented for us to abide by. But this is not a new edifice. This was my grandmama's church over 20 years ago. So we're not reintroducing these walls to Jesus. They already know Jesus. I am not one, in all due respect, Bishop Walker, because I have to be submitted to my pastor. He has every right to pull my coattail if I go too far. But I think one of the Achilles' heels to the kingdom is that we love protocol but don't love praise. We didn't put these walls up because we got rings and clergy collars. We put them up because we put feet on the floor. You know what I'm saying? I go to my shop. Now, you already know where you came, and some of my constituents don't like when I talk like this, but I feel an early breakthrough praise right now. My shop. Dr. Jamal just got on off the flight. Talk about wait. We don't wait, Jamal. I see you when you get here. Just bring your check and I'll take it. And you take cross street, get him some wings or something. But I'm not waiting. My pastor is here. He has a long schedule. We're not gonna put that pressure on him. We're gonna move through this program. I can do the offering because I know what I need. I know what I need. I know exactly how much I need, but I feel like dancing for a few minutes. Now, I'm going to give you the rules, and I know some of my worship center constituents in the here don't dance no more, but if you don't dance, you got to go outside until we finish. Because everything in here, when I move, everything moves with me. Y'all listen. I need you to touch your neighbor. If your neighbor don't holler back at you, if your neighbor, watch it, let me try. If your neighbor don't holler, if your neighbor don't speak in tongues, if your neighbor don't quicken, don't ever speak to them another day in your life. Because they are the infection to your next level. When you say this to your neighbor, if they don't shout, if they don't quicken, if they don't speak in tongues, then never speak to them another day in your life. Because they are the infection to your next level. Look at your neighbor in the face and say, neighbor, I want you to know one thing, and one thing only. Tell them the devil.
Themselves wandering in the wilderness. That's a lie. We didn't lose it. We walked away from it. Sold it and made made some money, y'all. Pastor Lee did. He made some money. Went to a little storefront on Government Avenue and danced right over there until dark. Paid that off cash. That's around the corner. We got another church in there right now. And my cousin back there called me, who raised me around the corner. I was raised right across the street. I'm a hood baby. I don't come from the suburbs. I was raised on Norma and Harford Road from Kent and Cuddy. I played basketball in the alley. I got my gold teeth from the corner of Cliffview, Dr. Lionel Russell. I had three gold teeth in my mouth. My name was Black then. They called me Bishop Mark. My name was Black. And God brought me back to this place because I believe there's victory on Harford Road.